Welcome back to Earth from Space. This Copernicus Sentinel-2 image features an area in the Wheatbelt region of Western Australia. The term Wheatbelt refers to inland agricultural areas in eastern and southern Australia, named for their production of wheat, which was the main agricultural product in the early history of Australia's development. Wheatbelt areas are usually arid, making agriculture largely reliant on rainfall and irrigation. The Wheatbelt is one of the 9 regions of Western Australia and lies in the southwest section of the state, covering an area of around 160,000 square kilometres. The region has an estimated population of around 75,000 residents. This image shows a part of the region which is very arid and is used mainly for agricultural production. The area is a major producer of wheat, barley, and wool, and is also used for livestock production, pastoral sheep farming, as well as horticulture. Fields have a distinctive appearance in this week's image, creating a colourful patchwork of geometric shapes. This composite image was created by combining 3 separate images, processed using the near-infrared channel. The first image, from the 9th of May 2019, is visible in shades of red. The second, from the 6th of September, can be seen in green. And the third, from January 2020, can be seen in blue. All other colours visible in the image are different mixtures of red, green and blue, and vary according to their stage of growth over the 9-month period. According to reports from the Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development, Western Australia's climate has changed over recent decades, with significant reductions in growing season rainfall. Climate variability and changing weather patterns strongly affect agriculture, increasing production risks for crops and pastures. Owing to their unique perspective from space, Earth observation satellites are key in mapping and monitoring croplands. The Copernicus Sentinel-2 mission is specifically designed to provide images that can be used to distinguish between crop types, as well as data on numerous plant indices, such as leaf area index, leaf chlorophyll content, and leaf water content, all of which are essential to accurately monitor plant growth.
Thank you.